think this is the first time I have ever conducted worship wearing a hat. But you'll excuse me because otherwise I'm going to sweat in my eyes and it's not going to go well. Fun to be up in front here at Messiah again, and it's my extra special pleasure to be doing this kind of off the wall, what I call a hoot nanny service, with my good friend Chris Robinson. You all know me at least a little, but Chris is, I have to apologize, I brought a Baptist pastor into the midst of the week.
Amen!
Preach it!
Chris and I have known each other for many, many years now, like 30, 20.
Oh, my back.
Yeah, no, it hurts. And as a bass player, I've had the privilege to play with a lot of different people. I have three guitarists that are my top three that I've ever played with, and Chris is in that top three. I don't tell him which one because I don't want him to get a big head. But the problem with us is that we're never known to decorum, so if things get out of hand, you know, you'll have to excuse us. But we'll join together in worship by singing our gathering song, which is I Saw the Light. It's on the front page of the book.
Is this the one that's in F?
This is in F.
Okay, good.
Maybe even though F.
like the word epistle. I thought it sounded a little too formal and abstract. And I would always say, reading from the letter of Rome, of Paul to the Romans or something like that. And then I actually learned that epistle is a technical term for a document that is in the form of a letter, but is really intended to be sort of a theological or philosophical treatise intended not just for the people to whom it's addressed, but to a broader audience, a worldwide audience, really. And so it is with the epistle of Paul to the Romans. Romans has been called Paul's magnum opus. It happens to be my favorite book of the Bible. And if I have Romans as my favorite book of the Bible, then the 8th chapter of Romans is my favorite chapter of my favorite book of the Bible. Sounds like there could be a song or something. But anyway, the whole 8th chapter could be thought of as kind of a template or a treatise on prayer, because it gives to us a very strong sense of to whom we pray, why it is that we are privileged to pray, and what we can expect from prayer, along with what we can expect from the one to whom we pray. And if you will, it sort of forms a Christian 911. For those people who are in the faith, for those people who have brought into the kingdom of God by virtue of their baptism, we confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It is, as I said, the 911. If you're in times of trouble, if you're in times of distress, who are you going to call? I can't help it, but now I've ruined it probably for you, that every time I read the 8th chapter of Romans, I get that theme song from the Ghostbusters rolling in my head. Who are you going to call? Not the Ghostbusters, but Christ Jesus. Actually fits pretty well. Who are you going to call? Christ Jesus. And I know that Messiah Church, like many others that I could name, is in a time of transition, in a time of change, a time of really self-examination, of looking for what will be our next phase, what is our new direction, and how is this going to all fit together. And will Messiah be the same old place that I always have appreciated while also doing something new as we ponder anew what the Lord can do? And so it is that in this time of change and flux in the church, which sort of matches a time of change and flux in society, we have that one concept, which is our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, God our Father, and the Holy Spirit. That one constant on whom we can depend for all things, to whom we are connected with a cord that can never be broken. Maybe that's the most important thing that Paul says. Because we are called into existence, each and every one of us, made by God to live in God's world, to enjoy God's creation. And here we are on perhaps one of the most beautiful days of a northern Ohio summer, enjoying the breeze, the trees, and we think to ourselves, what a wonderful world. But in all of creation, there is trial, there is trouble, there is sin. Our enemy death prowls around like a hungry lion, seeking to devour us. And yet God says, or sever. Paul writes, who can bring any charge against God's elect? And that is us, friends, God's elect. Elected not by our own reason, strength, or merit, but elected by the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus. Who can bring any charge against God's elect? It's God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Jesus Christ even died for us, Paul says. And Paul continues, I'm sure that that life nor death, not powers, not principalities, not things present, nor things to come, nor heights, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Who are you going to call? Christ Jesus. The one who ties us together with God in that most powerful of love. The love, the power of which created us and all that exists. So that it is. When there are times of change, times of distress, times when we feel out of sorts, we have that Lord on whom we call, the one constant in our lives. And think about it. Christ died for us, not just that we would have abundant life here today, for the rest of our earthly lives, but that we would share with him the heavenly kingdom. That kingdom that breaks in daily into our broken world. That kingdom which shows itself in bright summer days and soft, blessed nights. That kingdom that shows itself in the kindnesses of strangers and friends who say, I love you, in their greetings and in their fellowship. So it is, friends. Let's celebrate God's love for us, that constancy that God has for us. Let us know that the Holy Spirit informs our faith in him, and let us also know that we can never be separated from God's love. His name. Switch for that.
Now, So, I have a mic in my face, so I'm going to say something about our friendship. I thank John for helping me to find my way in this world. Several years ago, he introduced me to the idea of hospital chaplaincy. And as it turned out, and my wife will tell you, I'm not lying, that was the most, that was the best fit for me and my personality. So because of John, I was able to make a vocational choice that was really good. So I have to brag about John for that very reason, and I have to thank you for that, and wherever the opportunity presents itself, I will do that. It's really a cool thing to be here, be with all of you, saints, the church, and many of my good friends. Oh, I'm sorry, G. G.
All right, now we're there.
Do Lord of, do Lord of, do remember me. Do Lord of, do Lord of, do remember me. Do Lord of, do Lord of, do remember me.
light of understanding on your church on earth. Bind us together in the word to share your love with the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Protect birds in their nests, fields full of crops, the seas and the fish that swim in them. Inspire us to care for the creation you love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Raise up just and wise advocates and judges from small town courts to international tribunals. Enlighten all leaders to discern what is right and to do what is good. Lord, in your prayer, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Nurture faith in those who doubt. Lift up those who are weak in body, mind, or spirit. Heal the sick, comfort the grieving, and surround with love those facing their last days. We especially pray for Glenn, Joel, William, Fred, Carol, Judy, Wendy, Ron, Steve, Diane, and Jim. May they find peace and strength in their time of need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Expand the understanding of this assembly to see our neighbors as you see them. Let the yeast of our word grow beyond us to expand your boundless love to those around us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Sustain us by the impression, intercession of your Holy Spirit. Let your Spirit's sighs, too deep for words, comfort us until we rejoice with those already united with you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands we place our prayers, spoken and outspoken, trusting in the mercy of Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Let us confess our words in the faith of the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Please be seated and we'll join together in worshiping the Lord with our tithes and offerings.
Jay is noisy offering. Is that the same?
All right, thank
you. No kidding.
No kidding.
Pointed to